fear and courage are both states of mind. You choose, and they can exist at the same time. You can have both fear and courage at the same time, but choose which state of mind you want to have. Good day and welcome to another session of Women in Leadership with V. In this channel and in these episodes, we amplify the voices of women in businesses as well as in companies. I'm so used to doing this with somebody else, interviewing someone on the side. But today I thought I should bring you this special edition for Women's Month. So I'm flying solo and I'm gonna give you a few tips of the things that I've learned from life. So usually the episode will have two people, but I'm thinking, why not give you a few tips and just share the experiences that I learned from life? And these are the lessons that so far I've learned from life and I want to share with everybody. So the first lesson is, be you, do you, and be authentic in everything that you're doing. I see so many people trying to be somebody else, trying to emulate someone, try to copy someone, cutting and pasting into other people's lives. And that makes you a weaker version of yourself. Be you, do you. The world has got 8 billion people and there is none like you. There's none with your talents, none with your fingerprints, none with your experiences, none with your DNA. So why be somebody else if you can just be yourself? And if you become somebody else, you're robbing the world of you. So be you, do you, and be authentic. Being authentic, it's much, much simpler. If you're yourself, you don't need to think and try harder to be that. So be you, do you, and be authentic. My next advice, I wanted to say to women, say no. And then I realized that women all over the world are being told no, no, no. You can't do this, you can't do that, you can't be this, you won't be able to do this. And I framed this lesson as know when to say yes and know when to say no. Sometimes we say yes to burdens, to things that really don't take us forward because someone has asked, we feel we have to do it, our kids have asked, and we cannot say no. Learn how to say no when you need to and to say yes when you need to. So yes to adventures, yes to something that energizes you, and say yes to all the things that you've wanted to do, that you've always wanted to try. Say yes to those things, but say no to things that don't serve you. Say no to things that are not for you, and say no to things that really do not grow you in life. So my advice to you as the second advice is to say, learn when to say yes and when to say no. So that is my second advice for today. And the third advice that I want to give to women out there, to say, take risks. I wish somebody had told me to take risks when I was young. I think I would have been far. I didn't take enough risks when I was young. I tried to take more risks when I'm older, which is a little bit complicated. So take more risks when you're young, take more risks in your 20s, in all the aspects of your life. Take jobs that are way beyond you in your 20s, because if you fail, at least you can always go back home and you don't have the baggage when you go back home. So you can take risks in terms of the investments that you make, your career choices, and other things in life that you feel you can take risks. It's much better to take risks in your 20s rather than to take risks in your 40s, when you've got kids, you've got more baggage, you've got a house, you've got a car, and you've got other people to take care of, maybe especially your elderly parents. So what I will say to you, if you're still young, take risks now, because it gets complicated when you grow older. That was advice number three. Advice number four is a little bit related to advice number three, to take more risks, which was three. And advice number four is to take a decision. Take a decision today. Whatever you've been thinking about, whatever you have been wanting to do, take a decision to do it today. Sometimes we take one decision and we give up because things didn't work out. If you take a decision, your chances are 50-50. It's either going to go well or it's going to go badly. And if it goes badly, my advice is take another decision. I've seen so many people getting stuck with a decision that they took in their 20s, and they live the rest of their lives with the decision. If you take a decision in your 20s and in your 30s you realize that that wasn't the right decision to take another one. There is nothing that says you need to take one decision in your life and you're stuck with that decision. Take a decision. If you feel you're going the wrong way, take a decision to go the right way. If you think you took a decision in your 20s, take another one, because in your 20s, you didn't have enough information. So you took the best decision for that period of time. Take a decision today and take a little bit more risks. I'm not saying take risks and decisions that are reckless. I'm saying with the information that you've got, the life lessons that you've learned, take a decision. If you took one earlier and it didn't serve you, take another one. It's your decision to make. And if it's wrong, you can always take another decision. That was advice number four. Take a decision today. Whatever you've been wanting to do, do it. Start. Take a decision to do it. Advice number five, it's, I think I learned the hard way. I learned recently that fear and courage can exist together. And they can exist in one person. I used to be so afraid to make decisions, so afraid to take risks. And I would write down what if, and what if, and what if, and what if. Because those what ifs were based on fear. I was afraid. What if something goes wrong? What if I lose money? What if I take the wrong decision? What if I do this? What if? And one day I woke up and I found that I had a lot of what ifs. And none of them were what ifs that could kill me. So I thought, if none of these what ifs are gonna kill me, why can't I try something? Why can't I take a little bit more risks? And I decided I'm gonna take more risks. So when you start taking risks and taking decisions, there's always gonna be what ifs. Sit down, write down your what ifs. If the what ifs are not gonna kill you, they're probably gonna make you strong. So fear and courage can exist in one person. I do this podcast, I speak a lot, and each and every speech that I make, every time I speak, I am frightened, I am scared, and I don't know what I'm gonna say until I open my mouth and say it. And I usually just tell myself, have courage, be courageous, because I'm always, always scared to do something. So fear will always be there and courage will be there. And both fear and courage are states of mind you choose. So choose the state of mind that you want to be in and the state of mind that you want to have. You can live in fear the rest of your life, or you can be courageous and do all the things that you have been afraid to do. If it doesn't kill you, it will probably make you strong. And that was advice number 5. And I've got the bonus advice for you today, which I wish I also learned in my 20s, but I learned it a little bit late. And that advice is celebrate every win, no matter how small it is. Don't wait to make $1 million so that you can celebrate. Don't wait for the big ticket items so that you can celebrate. Celebrate every day. Make one step and celebrate. Stop and smell the roses. Celebrate, celebrate, celebrate. Because what you are celebrating is not the thing or where you are going or the thing that you want to achieve. You are celebrating the process. So celebrate the process. Celebrate the journey. And take time to just stop and celebrate. So what I do in my life, I've learned to celebrate small things. I do small things for myself. I do the massage. I do my nails. I buy myself flowers. And I just take myself sometimes out for lunch to say, wow, you've come so far. And I celebrate. So I wish I'd celebrated my birthday. I wish I'd celebrated my milestones while I was still young. I didn't celebrate because I felt like I don't have enough money. I don't have enough of this. I don't have enough of the time. But these days I celebrate. I stop and I celebrate. Whether I've got the money or I don't have the money, some things don't even need money. So celebrate. Celebrate your life. Celebrate the milestones. Celebrate the small things. And sometimes if you don't have anything to celebrate, celebrate the fact that you are alive, because that's important. There are some people who didn't get to that age. So you are alive. You're there. You've got troubles. You've got burdens, but you are still alive. You can still celebrate that part of being alive. So Women in Leadership with V, that's it. That's all we were bringing you today. Let me recap the lessons so that you don't forget them. Lesson number 1, be authentic. Be you, do you, because you are the only version that exists in this life. There isn't anybody like you. So use your strength, use your talent, and celebrate you. Be you and do you. And lesson number 2, know when to say yes and know when to say no. Say yes to things that energizes you, to things that build you up, to things that grow you, and say no to things that robs you of the energy and the things that make you tired and exhausted. That was number 2. And number 3, it's take risks. Take more risks. If you're young, take even more risks, but take calculated risks. And lesson number 4, take a decision today. Whatever you wanted to do, do it. You want to write a book? Start. You want to go somewhere? Book that holiday and do it today. Take a decision. And lesson number 5, fear and courage are both states of mind. You choose, and they can exist at the same time. You can have both fear and courage at the same time, but choose which state of mind you want to have. Ladies, celebrate, celebrate, celebrate. And that was it for today. This was a special edition to celebrate all the women of South Africa. And the Women in Leadership with V was brought to you by Diversity SA. Like us, share, and subscribe. Thank you. Bye.